Welcome to Maze World 365. I'm your host, the 21st Century, and I'm here with the legendary Roberta Flack. What's going on, Miss Flack?
Well, I'm celebrating the imminent release of my new album, which is an album of songs, music by the Beatles, and I'm very excited about it. The first single is out on iTunes. It's called We Can Work It Out, and indeed we can.
Absolutely. Now, you've influenced many artists. You made the song Killing Me Softly. How did the creative process go with that song in the studio?
Well, it was wonderful, and it's great that you asked me that question, because when I first heard the song, I had just finished working with Quincy Jones, doing a televised tribute to Duke Ellington, who was sick. And so they got myself and Sarah Vaughan and Aretha Franklin and Peggy Lee together, and we did a medley of Duke's songs for TV. You can see that on YouTube, as a matter of fact. But after I finished that TV special, I got on a plane and flew back to New York. And in the old days, they used to feature a brochure that told you what you could choose to listen to. You didn't have to turn through the whole book. Just a little tiny brochure. And on the title of this brochure, it said, Killing Me Softly with a Song. And something, you know how God speaks to you? Something that went off in my head. I hadn't heard the melody, didn't know what it was about. But just the title, I said, oh, okay, I like that. So then I listened to it maybe about 6 or 7 times as I was traveling from L.A. to New York. When I got in to New York, I called Quincy at his house, and I said, listen, do you know Charles Box and Norman Gimbel? He said, yeah, those are my buddies. I said, they wrote a song called Killing Me Softly. He said, and? I said, I want the song. He said, okay, I'll get in touch. And about 2 days later, I had the song. Fast forwarding the tape, I went to Jamaica at the end of the week. I had a little house down there in Jamaica, in Kingston. And I went down with my band. That was Ralph McDonald, Eric Gale, and a few other people, musicians, and Chuck Rainey. And we went down, Richard T., and went to Bob Marley's studio called Tough Gong, and rehearsed and practiced it and put down a couple of tracks. And then we came back to the States and went in the studio and did it for real. Before we went into the studio to do it, I did a performance with Quincy at the Greek Theater in L.A. And Quincy, you know, is the master musician. He had orchestrated all this music. There was a big orchestra, big band, horns, jamming, everything. I did Reverend Lee and songs like that from my earlier albums, and he did all of his stuff, you know, Killer Joe and everything. And we just had such a wonderful audience. A lot of famous celebrities were in the audience. At the end of our performance, I did First Time Ever, I Saw Your Face, and the audience loved it. But they wouldn't, I mean, that was it. He did one more song with the big band, and that was it. And so I came out and took a bow, and they would not stop clapping. He said, Ro, you got to do something. I said, what can I do? And he said, you know, do something. I said, should I sing First Time Ever again? He said, no. He said, what you going to do? I said, well, you know that song, Killing Me Softly? He said, yeah. I said, well, I can do that. I had not rehearsed it with the band. Called my band back out. We did Killing Me Softly. The audience went wild. And Quincy walked over to me and said, Ro, don't ever sing that song again until you record it, okay? I said, all right.
Because he knew it was a hit. Now, today's R&B, the genre, is blending in a lot with hip-hop. Do you feel like they're getting away from soul singing?
No. Music, the only thing that's definite and sure about music is that whether you like it or not, it will change. It will evolve. Can you imagine when you talk about people like Duke Ellington? Now, that's before your time and my time, too, really. But you know his name. Suppose he was still around doing music and that was your choice to listen to him. You would listen to him if you like, but you would not want to not hear Wyclef Jean. You would not want to have somebody you can't hear, Jay-Z and Alicia Keys, you know, and those other kids, Lauryn Hill. You want to be able to move with the world as it turns. And it does turn. And just like the music, the world turns and the pulse of music changes. It changes in such a profound way that it goes all over the world. I remember the first time I went to Japan And it was behind Killing Me Softly, and it was big, 50,000 people, and I was like overwhelmed. But you know what really knocked me to my knees? When the kids in Japan said, Miss Roberta, can we take you to a club? I said, yes, they took me to a club. All the kids in there had afros. These are Japanese kids with straight hair. They had afros that were like this, and they were dancing to Get On Up. You know, they were doing James Brown all across the floor. Music, if it has a pulse and it has a beat, especially one that relates to your heart, that everybody can feel. Definitely. Everybody can feel James Brown, even if they don't know what he's saying. When he squealed, you know, he said.
But it's my honor to interview you, my pleasure. Roberta Flack, the legendary Roberta Flack, Maze World 365 exclusive.
And she's got a big mouth, that's why she talks so much. Sorry.
It's all good, though. God bless you. Take care. Peace.
Whereas this advocate for music education has been an admirable social activist, an instrumental in the music business by opening doors for many new and aspiring artists, and for people of color. Defying odds and social restrictions, achieving musical greatness, while gracefully acting as an ambassador for the arts in underrepresented communities.
All right.
And whereas such accomplishment, which is truly the lifeblood of the community and the state, so often goes unrecognized and unrewarded, but not tonight. But not tonight. I said not tonight. Now, therefore, be it resolved, with your permission, that as a duly elected member of the great state of New York, State Assembly of New York, I recognize that in Miss Roberta Flack, we celebrate through the Inspired in New York series, an outstanding legend worldwide, an artist who is worthy of the esteem of both the Village of Harlem and the great state of New York.